Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So for this first DIY, we are going to start with this Halloween sign from Dollar Tree. I am going to sand the glitter off, but I do it over a trash can so it catches most of the glitter. Now I'm going to take this shimmer paint that I picked up from the craft section of Target. It's the color Egg, and it's a really beautiful pearly white color. And as I was painting it, I really didn't like the streaks that were being left by the foam brush. It was the only kind of paintbrush that I had at the time. And I remembered that I picked up this Pearl Mist spray paint from Rust-Oleum at Lowe's. So I took the sign out and I was aiming to cover up this streakiness from the foam brush, and it really did not cover up the streaks, but it did give it a really gorgeous pearly finish. And so this is what it looks like. It's still outside drying, and while it does dry, I'm going to head back inside, and to make the base of the Christmas tree, I'm going to use some of these tumbling tower game pieces, and I am going to glue them together using Gorilla Wood Glue. You can use hot glue or E6000, whatever type of glue you would like to use. And for the Gorilla Wood Glue, you really only have to use a little bit of it. Using this glue does take more patience because it's not as instant as hot glue. The thing with hot glue is it can dry so quickly, especially when it's a little chilly in the room, and I didn't want there to be any gaps in the wood, so that's why I decided to go ahead and use the wood glue. For the bottom part of the tree bottom, I'm going to glue four pieces together just like this. And then I'm going to glue the two pieces together, trying to center the top piece as much as possible. Of course, you can make whatever shape you would like to make. This is just the simple shape that I wanted to use. And now I'm going to let that dry completely. I don't want it to fall apart, so I gave it time to dry. And now I'm taking some burnt umber paint, and I am going to paint all of the edges, including the bottom edge and the front. I am not going to paint the back because that's where I am going to glue it to the sign, and I don't want the paint to interfere with the adhesion of the glue. So I'm going to give it a nice coat of paint. I didn't use too much. Now I'm going to take some black acrylic paint and a small brush from Dollar Tree, and using a sparse amount of black paint, I'm just going to kind of go up and down. And this is just to help give it more of a wood grain look. I know the blocks are wood, it's already wood, but I think the black really helps it make it look more like wood, if you know what I mean. So now that our board has dried, I'm trying to catch the light to show you like the really pretty pearly finish. It's a little difficult to do in indoor lighting, but trust me, it came out really beautiful. And now I'm just placing the bottom of my tree where I want it to be. And this is really just a guesstimate for me. You can decide how big or how tall you want your tree to be and then place the bottom of it where you want it to be. And for this part, I am using hot glue to adhere it to the board. Now to make our Christmas tree, I'm going to use four different sets of these mini ornaments from Dollar Tree. My favorite are the ones on the far left, the one that has the little hexagon shape on it. In fact, I think I'm going to go back and get more of those. Those are really pretty, and you can use those for other projects as well. So for the ornaments, I'm just going to twist off the little topper for the ornaments, and you're left with just the bottom of the ornament like that. And I am going to use hot glue to adhere all of the little ornament pieces that we are going to form our little Christmas tree with. You can use a stronger adhesive if you would like to, and I just want to alternate the colors and the finishes as much as possible. So I want to put a shiny one next to a glittery one, next to an opaque one, and then gold and red and silver all mixed up all the way up the tree until I have the shape that I want. So this is what I have so far, and it's looking a little rough, I know, but believe me, the end result is going to be really cute. We just need to do a little bit more work on it. I'm going to take these glitter vase fillers, also from Dollar Tree. They also have these in like a cranberry color in gold, but I really wanted to use these different shades of gold. And basically, I'm going to use this to help define the shape of the tree and to fill in any gaps where you can see through to the bottom of the board. And these really do help to give the tree dimension as well. This is what it looks like so far. And I'm taking some of the mini pine cones from the cinnamon pine cone fillers that Dollar Tree was selling for fall, and just placing those around, just a few of them. And this is what our tree is looking like so far. And it looks much fuller and more 3D than it did originally, just using the regular ornaments. I'm going to take this pick from Dollar Tree and take off the little poinsettias. There were only three of them. I'm taking off all three and adhering them with hot glue. Now, using this buffalo check and snowflake ribbon from Dollar Tree, I'm going to make a bow and two long tails. I glued the bow to the top of the tree, and now using this copper wired light. These are the battery operated lights from Dollar Tree. I'm going to just wrap it around. You only get 10 lights on one of these strands, so I'm trying to make the light go from the bottom to the top. And this is how it turned out. But I wasn't happy with it, so I took it down. Then I went back to Dollar Tree and I got one of these mini tree toppers. Now I'm going to take the bow and tails off the tree super carefully because I don't want to rip it. I do want to glue it back, and I need to remove this top ornament. Something went flying. I don't know what it was. I still haven't found it. And I don't know, maybe it was one of those little glitter balls that went flying. Who knows? Now, if you wanted to take the coil part off the tree topper and just glue the star down, you could of course do that as well, but I like the little coily part, so I left it. I just needed to put that top ornament in there, and I'm going to glue it down, and I'm going to use this little piece that I popped off of a Dollar Tree picture from a previous project and just use it to help that star stand up. Using hot glue, I'm going to glue my ribbon back to the tree right there. But instead of just letting it, the tails kind of cascade down, I'm going to form them, or, you know, help shape how they go down the tree. And I really do think this is better than just kind of letting it flop down on its own. It just gives movement to the tree, and I really do think it adds a bit of whimsy to it as well. And of course, Dollar Tree has a lot of options for ribbon this year, so you can use whichever ribbon goes best with the ornaments you choose for this project. I'm going to take one of these foam forms from Dollar Tree, and they are also selling these mini pine cones. These are like the frosted pine cones. They also have the regular pine cones without that frosted effect. And using hot glue, I'm going to go all around the base of the little cone form and add the mini pine cones all the way around. I took some pine cones out because they are all different sizes, and I wanted to use the largest ones at the bottom of our little pine cone tree first, and then I want to use the smaller pieces as the tree goes up. And I did use two bags of the pine cones, of the little mini pine cones, for this tree. So if you decide to make a larger tree, you are going to need more pine cones. But I'm pretty sure you've seen something like this at Home Goods, and it's going to cost a lot more money. At the bottom of the bag, I found these tiny pine cones, and I used those to fill in all the little gaps where you could see through to the foam center. Once I get to the top, I'm just going to keep going around in a circle, gluing the pine cones down, and it naturally comes up to a point. So you don't have to worry about the top being flat. If you keep gluing the pine cones around and around and around, it will naturally come up to a point. And for the very top, I chose one of the prettiest pine cones and set it right at the top as a topper. And now I'm going to take some of these little foam berries from this Dollar Tree pick and just glue them randomly around. I do go all the way around the tree with the berries, but I just wanted to show you guys what it looks like with the berries on it, and I think it adds just the perfect touch for this cute little mini pine cone tree. Now, for our next project, we're going to take this Buffalo Check placemat. And the great thing about this placemat, unlike the one that had lemons for the summer, this one is 95% cotton, so it makes for a better pillow than the lemon one, which had kind of like a vinyl backing. And I just want to cut a slit at the top, just large enough for me to stuff the pillow. But when I went to open it, I found that it was kind of fused together. So I'm just being patient and carefully kind of pulling it apart. And once I get my hand in there, I kind of move it around to help loosen up that the fabric from one another, the top from the bottom. And then I'm going to take some polyfill. You can use whatever you want. You can even cut an opening large enough to fit a whole pillow and just cover a pillow with this and treat this as a pillowcase. I didn't have any pillows that fit this form, so I'm going to use polyfill, and I did get this polyfill from Walmart. To close up the seam, I am going to use hot glue. You are welcome to sew it if you would like to. I just chose to use hot glue because it was faster. Now, using this ribbon, I got this ribbon last year from Dollar Tree. I wanted to make this a reversible pillow, so I'm going to make this side of the pillow look like a little present. And again, I'm just using hot glue. You can use fabric glue if you have that, or tacky glue, whatever you would like to use. And I'm making sure to glue down the edges of the ribbon because I don't want it to pop up. I want it to be flush all the way across. Thank you. I made a bow with the same ribbon and I'm just deciding where I want to place it. And once I've picked that position, I do go ahead and tie it off. And I'm removing a poinsettia from a pick and gluing it right to the center of that bow. And our little reversible pillow is complete. Now, I remade these little lanterns from Halloween lanterns into fall lanterns in a previous video. If you haven't watched that, I will link it for you in the description box below. But basically, I'm going to remove all of the little fall decor from the top of the lantern, and I'm going to use various picks from Dollar Tree, including this one with the frosted berries, to help decorate these lanterns. There is no plan here. I am just using hot glue and just trying different picks and different items on the picks and just seeing what looks good to my eye and using what I like. These lanterns are pretty tiny, so there were a lot of things that I wanted to use, but I couldn't because they were just too large for the size of the lantern. So, you know, just use whatever you have. And I decided this one needed a little bow on top. So I made another little shoelace bow with that same buffalo check ribbon. Then I used one of those iridescent gems from Dollar Tree for the center just to add a little sparkle to it. And for the next lantern, I decided to use a poinsettia from a Dollar Tree pick as well. And then I added one of the little mini ornaments. And again, more items from Dollar Tree picks. These were super simple to make, and you can change up the decor anytime. For our next project, I'm going to take this snow globe maker from Dollar Tree. It does come with a waterproof stopper, but I took that out because I'm not going to use water for this snow globe. And I'm going to take one of these red truck ornaments. I'm going to glue down one of the tumbling tower game pieces to the center of the lid, the inside of the lid. Now, if you wanted to, you could paint it white. I chose not to paint it white. I am going to cover it though. And I'm adding hot glue to the bottom of the tires of the little red truck ornament and trying to center it as much as possible right to the top of the wood block piece, and that's what it should look like. Now I'm going to take some of this glittery faux snow. If you can't find this, you can always use the little it's like foam ball snow that Dollar Tree carries, and I'm adding it to the snow globe. Guys, I added way too much. You're gonna see a pile on the table in a minute. But before we get to that part, I was having trouble fitting the little truck in. So what I did was I squeezed the top of the snow globe together, and that allowed enough space for the truck to fit in. But guys, look at all that snow I had to dump out. I was just worried that there wouldn't be enough to cover up the block. And so you really only need like a very little, maybe a quarter cup of it inside of the snow globe. And using one of these candlestick holders from Dollar Tree, I'm gonna add some hot glue to the lid of the snow globe. And this is just to help stabilize it. This is made out of plastic, so if it falls, it won't break. But I don't want it falling out, so I'm just adding bits of hot glue to help keep it in place. Now I'm going to take one of the tinsel pieces from Dollar Tree. I'm reusing this one from last year, and I'm going to wrap it around and just twist it at the back so it doesn't have to be glued at all. It has wire going through it so it'll stay in place. And more of these little frosted berries, and I'm going to wrap a piece around both sides of the snow globe. And I did use hot glue to keep that in place, and that's what it looks like. Now, I did not like this little thing right here showing, and unfortunately it is not true center of the snow globe, but anyway, I just wanted to cover it up. So I clipped off the bottom and used some hot glue to cover up that little round part. And now here are all of our projects. I think this little pinecone Christmas tree is my favorite project out of today's project. Drop a comment below and let me know which one of these was your favorite, and if you are going to recreate any of them. This little tree, I think it really is my favorite, and in fact I may make a couple more in different sizes. Here is one of our lanterns turned on, and of course these come with the battery operated LED lights already in them, and this is our second one. And like I said, you can always change the decor out as the season changes. If you see new picks that you want to use, you can just change them out as often as you like. Here's the little topper that I made for the snow globe, and I really wanted to give it more of a cloche look instead of a snow globe, and I think it turned out so super cute. Drop a comment below and let me know what you would put in this snow globe. And here is how our little Christmas tree sign turned out. The great thing about this sign is you can put it in a hallway, you can put it in a bathroom, whatever little space where you want to bring a bit of Christmas to it, but you don't have enough space for a true tree. A sign like this is a great solution. It's even great for an office. If you know someone, or if you work in an office, you can just make one of these. It lights up. You can add more lights if you want to. Super adorable, nice and glittery and sparkly. Great for this season, and it doesn't take up any space. And here is our really cute reversible winter pillow. You can make one side look like a gift, and the other side is a seasonal buffalo check. Yes, you are, Keiko. Yes, you are. Thank you guys so much for joining me for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed these projects. Please stay tuned for a lot more winter and Christmas decor DIYs. I have so many things planned for you guys. Thank you so much for your support. Please go ahead and subscribe for more content, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Until then, have a wonderful, a beautiful, and a blessed day. Until next time, bye.